So many people around the world want to know what's happening in Israel right now. Why has Israel suddenly disintegrated into riots and rockets and war and chaos? Why was the Temple Mount in flames on Jerusalem Day? After 2 years of almost complete peace and quiet, what has caused this sudden eruption in Arab society all across the land of Israel? So I want to address this question on three levels, because without understanding all three, you can't really understand what's happening in Israel. So first, internationally. In 2020, when the Republicans were in office, there wasn't a single Israeli killed in a terrorist attack. Until the Biden administration took office, only then, on December 20th, at the end of the year, the first Israeli was killed after what seemed like years of peace and quiet and prosperity. In April 2021, President Joe Biden wired $235 million in aid to the Palestinians. That money is going directly to pay the families of terrorists to kill Jews. And in this incredible act of colonialism, these funds are going to fund and organize these riots in Israel. Money is being distributed to the heads of small Arab tribes called Hamulot with orders, you want this money? Get your young men in the streets and set Israel on fire. Maybe then America can come in and save us and bring us a new peace deal. Not only are they backed by US and the European money, but the public stance against Israel has changed. The State Department just last month came out publicly saying so. So while wiring the Palestinians funds, the State Department took a sharp U-turn, and now they started labeling Judea and Samaria, the occupied West Bank, a public signal that America is now encouraging Israel to retreat from her homeland and establish another Gaza Strip in the heart of the land of Israel. Now, Arab rioting is a part of the Arab culture in the Middle East. Look at Lebanon, Syria, Egypt, Jordan, ISIS, Iran, Iraq. There's nothing new here in Israel, but funded by America and Europe, while Israel is functioning at record levels of incompetence with a fifth election on the horizon in 2 years, it's led us to a lack of order that the forces of chaos erupt, which brings us to our next point. Internally, what's happening in Israel right now? Well, at this point in history, America and Europe can do whatever they want, but a strong Israel is now the master of her own destiny. But a weak Israel, a divided Israel, an incompetent Israel is easy prey for the enemy. The lack of political unity and leadership and the personal vendettas that are driving our political leaders is literally driving Israel into the ground and dragging us into war. Our neighbors here are not friendly Canadians, and every regime in the Middle East that is not able to bring law and order and ensure peace and prosperity is subject to this chaos. Now, on a social level, we as a country are getting exactly what we deserve. When there's an 80-plus right-wing government elected by a people that can't form a fake government without Meretz, Mirav Michaeli, and Ahmad Tibi, when our country is back in cafes and gyms and our economy is roaring back while most of Europe and the Western world is still fumbling through trying to figure out Corona, and all you see in Tel Aviv are stickers saying, Lech! Go. It's just disgusting. The social solidarity and the baseless hatred that is rising up in Israel now is leading us to this social disintegration that we're seeing right now. And that, of course, leads us to the next level, which is spiritually. You think you can take God out of what's happening in Israel? You think you can divorce the Bible from the land of Israel? That's not possible. Every lesson of the Bible, all of our mistakes of our past are playing themselves out right before our eyes. Our lack of gratitude, our lack of unity, our lack of social solidarity, the high levels of hate and disdain in our society, the lies and betrayals of our right-wing politicians. These things aren't haphazard. They are our laws that govern Israel. And when we break those laws and try to bend reality for our own agenda, it's only a matter of time until reality snaps back on us. I mean, you think Corona is over? You think this virus was about a vaccine? You think the Temple Mount was on fire on Jerusalem Day? That's not a wake-up call, just a coincidence. I mean, friends, we're about to enter into a new era. And you think Israel has returned to her land after 2,000 years and we're just gonna stop here? Like, all right, this is it now. Sorry, a process has started and it's not going to stop until we see a new Jerusalem, world peace, and a new consciousness across the world. So get ready. All of this is a part of the process, and all of this is coming. I hope this helps make order out of all this chaos, but know that every obstacle placed in the face of Israel isn't God hiding himself from Israel. He's quite literally intervening Israel, giving us obstacles to show us the way, in order to make us more united, in order to make us stronger. And if you want more truth from the land of Israel, come on down to the Land of Israel Network at thelandofisrael.com, one of the only sources in Israel where you can really see what's happening in Israel behind the headlines, uncensored, the truth of what's happening in Israel.